The inevitable seems to have happened as the Delhi University declares the cut-off point for admission in colleges. We realize the absurdity of the entire process. The fact that in some branded colleges, in certain academic disciplines, 100% has become the cut-off point for admission, it by no means reveals the high quality of school education in the country, nor does it speak very high about the state of higher education in the country. Instead, it indicates the pathology of our education system, the vicious cycle of rote learning and inflated marks, and an ugly process of entering into colleges and universities. It is in this context there are three quick points that I wish to make sense of this entire phenomenon. First, it has to be realized that what goes on in our country in the name of school education is extremely lopsided, absurd, and pathological. The entire experience of learning, the spirit of wonder, the curiosity, the joy, all qualitative experiences are ruthlessly killed because we tend to put great emphasis on the quantification of performance, and as a result, everything is reduced into knowledge capsule, a set of bullet points as instructed by teachers and coaching centers, Ramhon Roy 2.0, 6 quick facts about Gandhi, a mathematical theorem to solve a trigonometric equation, or a riddle to solve a numerical of physics. Entire experience of learning is reduced into learning a set of techniques or an act of consuming instantaneous knowledge capsules. This leads to rote learning, and this leads to inflated marks in the age of objective, fact-centric questions and the absence of all qualitative articulations and expressions. And as a result, in a system of this kind, we see that people are getting 100% in English, in physics, in mathematics, and it does by no means indicate one's academic curiosity and academic excellence. It only indicates one's ability to master the exam strategy and the exam technique. So it is absurd, it is violence, and one ceases to be a learner with curiosity and wonder, one becomes merely an exam warrior. So there should not be any illusion that 100% in physics or English literature does necessarily indicate one's scientific temper or one's literary sensibility. And the second point that I wish to add is that that entire faulty process of entering into colleges and universities. In the age of ranking, two things happen. First, disciplines are being ranked and hierarchized. So it is assumed that there are certain prestigious disciplines which are more in tune with the rationality of the market. Say, for example, physics, commerce, economics, management, and students, irrespective of their choices and inclination, are often inclined to opt for those prestigious disciplines. And that does not necessarily match with their inherent curiosity or inherent urge. And second, also, the colleges and the universities are ranked and hierarchized. And that often leads to another notion of consumption. A young mind seeks to consume a branded college, LSR or Miranda House, at any cost. And even one might sacrifice one's original interest in certain discipline in order to get admission into certain branded college. I might be interested in history, but I'm not getting admission in Stephenson history, but it would do if in Stephens I get admission in geography. So I might sacrifice my subject, my choice of discipline, my inclination, because I wish to consume a particular brand, a particular college. Because of these two processes, a student's entry into colleges and universities becomes highly faulty, and this explains that entire absurdity and the politics of the cut-off point. And thought pathology, I would tend to argue, is that it has led to terrible hyper-competitiveness, a pathological culture causing depression. Under the system of education, with rote learning and inflated marks at school level, it becomes exceedingly difficult even not to get 80% marks. As a result, we find a generation suffering from acute depression if one has not got 95% in the board examinations. In an age of this kind, we are perpetually redefining success and failure. And this leads to the absurdity, 100% cutoff in certain disciplines, in certain branded colleges, causing widespread anxiety, the chronic fear, and it would affect large section of young students and their anxiety-ridden parents, and that entire joy of learning, experience of learning, the process of growing up would become completely upset, filled with terrible anxiety, chronic fear, and violence. Is there any way out? The kind of ugly system of education that we have created, and the violence that it causes, and the way it damages, kills, destroys human possibilities and creative possibilities. Is there any way out? This is something I believe that we all, parents, teachers, educationists, ought to think about. And as I would argue, right now, as it exists, 100% cut-off in branded colleges does by no means reveals the high quality of education. It only indicates our collective failure, the ugliness of success, the pathology of the prevalent pattern of education, which is based on the fetish of percentage of marks.